What is up, guys? This is Jared Spalding here, and yes, I am doing this in a different room. You know, it's just because of the fact that the lighting I'm trying to get, I don't know. It's kind of weird looking, I understand now, because of the different lamp in here, but I am sorry for that. But I was just trying to see if any lighting would be any better in here, and it kind of looks like it's a different type of lamp, so the lighting kind of looks more spread out, more dispersed, I think, at least. But that's not really too important. Today, what I'm going to be discussing is how to get the most silver for your money, you know, how to get the, with the amount of money you have, you know, how to get the most silver, how to get the most silver per dollar. However you want to word it, doesn't really matter, again, because the point's the same, you know, just how much silver can you get with your money. And honestly, this is universal, because no matter how much money you have, you want to, if you're trying to maximize, you know, your amount of silver, it's per dollar, it's not, you know, like you have this set amount of money, you can get this amount of silver, it's not like that, you know. It's like when you take an equation of math, right, and then you plug in variables instead of actually having, numbers in there. You know, you just have variables, and it's the same thing. You can plug in whatever amount of money you want, and it's still going to apply. So, anyway, honestly, it really just, I think, I don't want to say really depends, because I say it all the time, but really, I think it does kind of depend, honestly, on, how you want to build your stack, and really, of course, you can't completely rely on this, but because you do need to diversify a little bit. But I would recommend generic bullion and junk constitutional silver as the two main ones for this. Now, generic bullion, honestly, it's kind of, you know, very the same for me. It's like, you know, you can find decent deals, but it doesn't get amazing. You know, with generic bullion, you'll honestly, you're going to want to go with 5 to 10 ounce bars, I'd say. Anything larger, it's not going to be bad, but at the same time, I mean, because I don't believe, you know, like, it's going to be harder to sell if the price spikes or anything like that. That doesn't make any sense, if you really think about it. But I do believe that they're a lot harder to store much larger bars, you know. And honestly, I'd rather have 25 ounce bars than a 100 ounce silver bar, personally. I know a 100 ounce bar would be a little bit more compact. But I feel like there's more I could do with 25-ounce bars. Like, a 100-ounce bar, you have to sell the whole thing at once. And if that were a decent amount of your stack, you know, you could just, but if you just wanted to sell 25 ounces of silver, then you could just sell 25 ounces of silver, right? That's something that I think, personally, would benefit me. If I only wanted to sell part of my stack because maybe I had to, I don't want to sell the whole thing, you know. That's just a thought of mine, you know, that just occurred to me. But anyway, I would say, yeah, just go with at least 5 ounce bars. Try to buy in bulk when you can, you know. However much currency you're willing to spend, put it all into generic bullion at once. Don't hold back, because the more you can get, the better of a deal you're going to be able to get. I mean, that's simple, you know. And I'm sure that if you're buying in a large enough bulk, you're going to be able, you know, you're going to find people who are willing to give you a little bit of a deal. But that's really it. I mean, it doesn't really get much more complicated. Now, with the junk constitutional silver, we're talking about a whole different game now. It's really going to be sideways on me. There we go. You know, but that is what we're talking about. Alright, I'm sorry. We are talking about something completely different, though, you know, because at this point, it's not so much, you know, certain select price. It's almost like you're either going to pay too much or too little, you know, because this stuff is considered fractional, and it's the only fractional silver that's worth investing in, honestly, because, you know, if you get the fractional bullion, you're going to get ripped off. That's the way it works. The premiums on that's ridiculous. But this, you can buy a large bulk, you know, buy the roll or whatever. Usually how I'd recommend buying silver, if you can, is buy the roll, because that's going to be the cheapest way, you know. I think people will stop to give it as much as a fractional silver as, you know, they'll just think if the whole roll is one piece. And so it will, you know, sell as if it were just one solid piece. Plus, selling out 40 coins, you know, with a high premium on them, you know, 40 individual coins, so like one coin to the one person, it's going to be, the shipping cost, it's going to be so high that they'd make a lot more just selling by the roll, honestly. Because, really, if I were to, like, let's say I had just, I don't know, say I had a decent amount of silver nickels, right? And I wanted to sell all of them, because I figured, you know, wow, I bought a roll of these, and I paid, how much a roll would go for right now, maybe $50. I mean, that's kind of a little bit more than you want to be paying right now, I think, with prices. So let's say 45, right? Let's say you paid 45 for a roll. And then you're thinking, oh, wow, I could sell these for two a piece and get 80 bucks. Well, people aren't going to really do that because the shipping cost kind of prohibits it. It's not like selling at a coin store, which, you know, buying one coin at a time at a coin store, I definitely would recommend against, and most people would realize not to do that unless you're just kind of someone who's messing around with it. You know, you think, oh, silver, it's cool. But, yeah, most people online are not going to be selling individually. So, therefore, you know, you don't really have to worry about that too much. It's honestly kind of forces people to sell this as if it's one, you know, solid piece, at least a roll. And maybe half rolls, but even that's when you start to get into, you know, it being a little bit worth less to your territory just because of the shipping problem. So, you know, that's honestly why you can kind of get away with buying this stuff, even though it's fractional bullion, is because of the fact that, you know, people are forced to sell it in larger amounts. And if you can buy it in larger amounts, then you'll be good. I know ATMEX and places like that, they're going to rip you off. I mean, you know, it's not a deal at all. But, however, if you go into online auctions, right, you know, ones on eBay or wherever you're going, I mean, eBay usually will have people who don't know as much because it has a wider audience, and so even though there's more people, less of them are devoted to coin stacking, or coin collecting and silver stacking. Sorry about that. But anyway, you know, there's going to be so many more people on eBay that there might be some newcomers who come in and don't know what it's worth, and that might be everybody, and you might end up getting it or may end up going way too high, or you might end up getting a good deal on it. I mean, I've gotten some of the best deals on Newsmax on eBay, but also, I've managed to pay under melt for silver before. Either that, or just people who are selling a decent amount. Say they got three rolls of nickels that they haven't been able to move at all. You come in, you offer them a little bit of a lowball offer for all three rolls, and they accept it. You know, you're amazed they accept it, and you pay under melt. I've done that before, you know, managed to make people offers that I guess they couldn't refuse. I don't know. You know, in all seriousness, though, you know, as long as you have a decent amount of currency to spend, you kind of have more power than other people in the market, and therefore you can get more silver. So with this, it's kind of like, it's not like as constant as bullion, you know, the deals you're going to be seeing, but if you have the time and the patience for it, you can find a really good deal on silver and end up, you know, getting it for way cheaper than you should have, or you would have normally. So anyway, that is my take on it. Let me know yours in the comment section below, but I do hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful for you guys. I'm going to try to live stream soon. I'm trying to figure out all that stuff, so if you guys do want to see that, then let me know in the comment section below as well. But that really is it for this one now. Peace, love, and much respect.